Hi everyone, welcome to tutels.com. Today we will be discussing about the topic speed and velocity. So we have previously discussed about distance and displacement. So I'll do a quick revision about it. Imagine that this car is going in the clockwise direction from point A to point C. So from point A to point C, my distance would be 7 meters. As I have always told you that you need to mention the units. If you forget it, you'll lose your marks. And the distance from A to C would be my initial position being A and the final position being C. So I'll draw a line connecting the two. You'll have to draw a straight line. And then since it is a right angled triangle now, so AC square equals AB square plus BC square, which will give me AC as 5 meters by using the Pythagoras theorem. Now what I'll do next is, see now here you have to see that distance only has magnitude in it. Magnitude is this value 7 meters, and displacement has both this magnitude as well as the direction, which is like south east. Here we have done the position, we know how to mention the direction of an object. What I'll do next is, suppose that it takes to travel AB, the car, it takes like 4 seconds to travel here, and for BC it takes 6 seconds, and for CD it takes almost like 5 seconds. It's a rough estimate, okay? So the time taken to cover AC would be 6 plus 4, that is 10 seconds, and similarly the time taken to cover the distance, see, for this displacement, the total time taken will remain the same, that is this. So it will also be 10 seconds. Here I have divided, on the left I have divided the distance with time, and on right I have divided the displacement with time. Distance divided by total time taken gives me speed, and the displacement divided by the total time taken gives me velocity. The symbol which is used to mention both the units, both the terms, is V, and the units of both the terms is meter per second. Like that is common between these two. For a long path, for a long distance, the average speed is, it does not remain same, or the average velocity does not remain same. So for that, we have average speed and average velocity. You must have seen 2 meters on your car or the vehicle that your father is driving. So one of them is odometer and the other is speedometer. Odometer, it measures the distance, this distance, and the speedometers, it measures the instantaneous speed. Now why did I say instantaneous speed? Because at that very moment, the total distance that is covered by him in the time taken, in the time which is mentioned, that gives us the instantaneous speed. Continuing with this, the speed, it gives us only the magnitude. Speed of a body is the distance traveled by the body in unit time, and is defined as, and is mathematically written as, distance traveled upon time taken. The formula which is used is V equals S by T, where S is the distance and the T is the total time taken, and the unit for this is meter per second. Now average speed is represented by, you write V and then in the base you write small av. So this av represents the average and V represents the speed. Average speed is the total distance traveled by the total time taken. So what I'll do is, the total distance traveled for A to C is 4 plus 3 plus 4, that will give me 11 meters. And the total time taken would be 4 plus 5 plus 6, which will give me 9 plus 6, that is 15. So I'll write it as 15. So this is my average velocity, which is 11 by 15 meter per second. I can, just simplify this or let it be like that. Next, I have velocity. So for A to C, as I told you earlier, the displacement is 5 meter and the time taken was 10 seconds. So I will get my velocity as 0.5 meter per second. It has both magnitude as well as the direction, and is the defined as the displacement of the body per unit time taken. Mathematically, it is given as velocity equals displacement upon total time taken. For average velocity, we have two formulas. First, the total displacement by total time taken. So for example, if I'm going from A to D, so A is my initial and D is my final position. So my displacement would be 3 meters. Total time taken would be, so for example, 4 meter was 4 seconds. This is 6 and this is 5. So I'll get as 15 seconds. So total time taken is 15 seconds. So I'll get the answer as 0.2 meter per second. Be it speed, average speed, velocity, average velocity, the units are same, that is meter per second. Now average velocity, it is initial velocity plus final velocity by 2. Or I can say the mean of the initial velocity and the final velocity. Initial velocity is represented by u. Since it started from A, so my initial velocity is 30 meter per second. Final velocity is represented by V. And since it's landing on D, my velocity mentioned there is 15 meter per second. So that is my final velocity. Mathematically, average velocity, as I told you, for average speed, it would be V with the symbol AV written. So average velocity is the mean of two. So that would be the mean of these two, which I'll get as 80 divided by 2, which is 40 meter per second. I hope these many formulas and the concept is basically clear to you. You don't need to memorize it or revise it. Just remember the basic concept to remember it. Now next, let's solve a quick question. So Usha swims in a 9 meter long pool. Let me first make a pool which is 9 meter long. So yeah, it's not straight, but let's imagine it to be a little straighter. So she covers 180 meter in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other and back along the same straight path. So she went and she came back to the same position. Now find the average speed. So for average speed, I first have to take the distance. So the distance covered here is 180 meter. And then I have to take the time. Now, as I have told you earlier, what you need to do is you need to divide the distance. You need to ensure that the units are same. So for this, we have meter and here it is minutes. So I need to convert this minutes to second. Now my 1 minute has how many seconds? It has 60 seconds. So what I'll do is I'll divide this 180 meter, that is my distance, with this 60 seconds, which is my time. And I'll get the average speed as 3 meters per second. Now for average velocity, we have the displacement upon time. Since my initial and the final position are same, so the displacement is 0. So the 0 divided by 60 seconds will give me 0 meter per second. And that is my average velocity. Let's see how it works out. So my average velocity is 3 meter per second. We have converted the minutes into seconds. And thus, I have got 3 meter per second. Now for average velocity, I have my displacement as 0 meter and total time taken as 60 seconds. So I will get my answer as 0 meter per second. Next, let's just summarize it quickly. So my rate of motion is speed or velocity. Speed along with direction gives me velocity. Let me just put it as dir. So it gives me velocity. Speed is calculated as distance upon time. Velocity is displacement upon time. For average speed, we have total distance traveled by total time taken. For average velocity, we have two formulas, net displacement upon total time taken or initial velocity, thus final velocity divided by two. That is the mean of the initial and the final velocity. The unit of both is same, that is meter per second. I hope this part is clear to you. In case of any query, please do write in the comment section. You can visit the site tutorial.com for further questions and for further videos related to the same topic or different topic. We provide you materials from grade 1st to 10th for science and maths, and you will get practice questions and test questions there, which will be evaluated as soon as you submit it. So you'll get your graph. Thank you for being here. Hope you have a great day. And stay safe. Take care.